Everybody.
Mr. President, any thoughts on John McCain? Mr. President, any thoughts on John McCain, sir? Any action to the American Legion asking you to put a proclamation about John McCain?
I'm going that way, John Carl.
Why won't you say anything about John McCain?
Great debaters, Bakari Sellers and Rick Santorum. Can you dignify that for us, Rick?
Look, I just don't think it does anything to the memory of John McCain to use him as a cudgel to beat up the president at this point. I mean, let's focus on the man and what he did and his life. But the media seems to have this fascination to try to use the death of John McCain to further belittle and beat up Donald
you
Trump.
You think we need this to find reasons to criticism? You think we need to do that to find reasons to criticize the president?
Well, you are, whether you need to or not.
This
doesn't really matter. You're doing it.
That matters, Rick, and you should think about how you behave in it as well. All of us do. These moments matter. John McCain made a point to not have him invited to his funeral. Why?
So why don't you beat up on John McCain for not inviting the president?
Because I don't think he was wrong to do it. It's his funeral.
Well, okay,
and it's
so
about what he thought mattered.
You're not beating up on
John
McCain.
He's not a cudgel.
You shouldn't beat up on the president.
He's not a cudgel. I'm not beating up on the president. I'm playing his words. And the fact that you would see those as inherently indicting of his behavior, I think, puts the point out there for everybody, Bakari, because in moments like this, you guys all get measured who want to lead the rest of us. How do you act? What will you project? What do you make it about for the rest of us? The president took that opportunity, and he did what he wanted to with it. Fair point.
I think what we're seeing right now is that Donald Trump has turned this Republican Party into one of cowardice. I mean, you see good people like Rick Santorum who contort themselves into pretzels trying to defend the behavior of the president of the United States today. I mean, the fact is you have John McCain, who's a war hero. I mean, even my Democrats, even the people who are on the left who want to chastise him for whatever his policy may have been, we're saying that now is not the time. But you have a president of the United States who doesn't believe he's a president of moral authority. He doesn't believe that he's anyone who has to stand up and show the rest of the world that the United States is the beacon of morality, the beacon of what it means to be ethical, the beacon of what it means to be a leader in the world. You have a president who's small, who's petty. Who's a sociopath. I mean, I'm not a doctor, but defamation, as you know, Chris, the absolute defense is absolute truth or a piece of truth. And I can tell you that he has a dose of psychopathy. But you have a president today who did not stand up. You have a president this week who did not stand up and show the best of what we can be. And that's a problem. John McCain deserves all the glory today. John McCain is a Republican who I can honestly say that if my son wants to be a Republican when he grows up, be like John McCain. We can live in that America. That's okay. You don't have to kowtow like Rick's doing right now on TV and make excuses for a president who does not deserve excuses.
Well, Rick, you agree with Bakari about what to remember about Senator McCain and what he represented for your party, right?
I do, and I've commented on it. I will continue to comment, you know, that John McCain was a great American. I didn't always agree with John McCain on the issues, but John McCain was a great American.
And you don't need to for him to be a great American, even a great politician. You don't have to agree with him.
I understand that. But to suggest somehow that the president didn't heap praise on John McCain and that made him a lesser person because he wasn't as effusive in praise as others were, I just think is the reason that you see so many Americans.
He said nothing for 2 days.
He did not say nothing. He tweeted out immediately his respects.
Condolences to the family. That's what a president says when you lose a major.
But I mean,
Chris,
let's just be honest. I mean,
Chris,
I understand that.
I think you're wrong here. And with all due respect to you and to Rick both, I actually think that you're wrong here. You're expecting more of Donald Trump than we expect of him. I mean, Donald Trump is the same person who believed in birtherism, whereby John McCain was someone who took the mic
This is why nobody listens to the media, Bakari, because you just keep this.
But how is that not true?
When
I say something that's not true, you chime in. The president was the original person who was beyond birtherism. That's what he believed in. What John McCain actually took the mic from someone who thought that Barack Obama was Muslim, so she could not hear what he had to say. I mean, these are two vastly different individuals. And so, yes, I disagree with you. I disagree with Chris. I disagree with both of you all tonight because I don't have a level of expectation higher for Donald Trump. If Rosa Parks and everyone else has said it best. You know, you have to believe people when they tell you who they are. Donald Trump has shown to be who he is. And today, for some reason, Chris and everyone else have a higher expectation or level of expectation for Donald Trump. I do not. What we know is that John McCain is a great American. Donald Trump, in his death,